In this video, we'll be covering CIC Asset Management Limited, and we'll be looking at how to fill the application form for the individual form. So, as we can see, nothing changes with the video initially sent for Sanlam. You need to fill in your title. This is your surname. So, this is your father's name, and then your two other names. Then you need to fill in either your ID or passport number, indicate your gender, date of birth, the KRA PIN certificate, which you'll attach as part of the documents you'll scan to them, mobile number important for the purposes of sending money to you and communications. So I understand from my readers, anytime you deposit money, they'll send you an SMS, or anytime there's action on your account, they'll send you an SMS, which is a good feature that I love with Sanlam. So it's good to see it here. This is your marital status, your postal address, and the code in the town. You will need the email address for official correspondence, nature of your occupation, so how do you earn your money. This is your signature field. Then again, for purposes of anti-money laundering checks, everyone these days is asking for the source of your funds. They want to see if it's legitimate, so you'd fill in what the source of the funds you're investing in are. For most people, it will be their salary. And then your customer bank details, again, very important, and they will need a copy of a certified recent bank statement, or recent copy of a certified check, or a certified copy of an ATM. So normally I go with this option of certified copy of an ATM card, but I always advise that you just send the top part of the ATM card. You don't want people stealing the information and using it online. You fill in the account name as it appears on the ATM card, your account number, the branch name, the bank name, and then you'll tick the nature of the account. Normally it should be a current account, and then the signature of the signatories for that account. What I would like to mention is their bank is solely cooperative bank. So if you bank with cooperative, you have the added advantage of not incurring monthly fees for sending money to CIC. I would also like to point out at this juncture that you want to set up a standing order of the amount that you want to contribute each month towards your money market fund. This is not only to benefit on the power of compounding, but to also prevent yourself from relying on your willpower or your memory to invest. The next thing is the bank details. So this is where you'll send your money, put in all the details. If you're setting up a standing order, again, put in all the details so that this can be automated for you. Then they have a higher minimum investment for Sanlam is 2,500. For them, they require that you invest a minimum of 5,000. And in this case, I'm recommending the money market fund. Otherwise, if you're interested in higher returns but more risk in terms of losing your capital in the worst case scenario, or even a portion of your capital, then you may consider some of these options. Then you indicate the number, the amount in words, the amount that you've invested in that section. Payment method, so this is how you are paying for your initial investment. Again, I prefer direct transfer, especially because of the added nature of doing a standing order, but you can as well do the check or M-Pesa or a cash deposit. Just want to mention that if you're using M-Pesa, they have their pay bill number here. And obviously you want to choose reinvestment, because this allows you to automatically benefit from the power of compounding. You want to make regular top-ups, should be at a bare minimum of 5,000 or above. Watch my video on the power of compounding just to determine, based on the goal, your future goal, how much you should be investing now. And then obviously you want the free email correspondence, These are the people that will be contacted in case something happens to you. These will be your beneficiaries. This depends. If you haven't, like in my case, the answer would be no. I'm not an employee of CIC, so that would be no. How did I hear about this? This would be the internet, and this again is from the Telegram group. Special mention to Jeremiah for giving us the information on CIC. If you look at my other lesson on calculating the true value or the true return of a money market fund, we were able to calculate in the Telegram group and realize that CIC offer a rate of 9.67 compared even, which is higher even than Sanlam at 7.46, if I'm not wrong, net of fees, which is a great thing. And also their return fits within the threshold that I discussed on the Telegram group in regards to if the return you're being offered is higher than the 360/40 bill, then you want to ask yourself, am I taking on higher risks for the return? And if it's lower than the 91-day T bill, which currently is at 7%-ish, is that fund manager optimizing your returns? And are you taking losses for something they did in the past? So, but if you want more insights on this, you can look at the web post on the Telegram group. As with all the fund managers, they require your residential details. So this is a number you get from your landlord, the house number, the road and the area. Again, this is to verify that you're a true person earning genuine income here in Kenya. And then you want to fill in this risk assessment form. I like these forms because they tell you your risk appetite. And maybe you can use the first three questions to assess what the likely outcome would be if you fill this form. So for somebody who fills in, for example, that they're 18 to 30 years and they want to invest for over 10 years and they have most of these investments, chances are that the form will recommend them to invest in an equity fund, because that is somebody who has the time to take on the risk, and also again, depending on how you answer most of these things. So like, do you have an emergency fund? Somebody with an emergency fund again would be able to take on more risk. So fill this in just for the purposes of knowing your true risk appetite. But again, as I mentioned, we are only discussing money market funds in this lesson, so this is where you'd fill in the amount you want to start with, regardless of what you get in this section. Blah blah blah. Things you need to know. If you understand those things up there, then you sign and you date this. As I mentioned again, CIC have performed a background check on me, so I am authorized to be an advisor and to recommend CIC to others. As I mentioned, you'll need an ID or your passport attached there, your KRA pin, a passport photo, and evidence of the banking details. So that can be an ATM card, top part, bank statement if you want to share that, or a cancel check. Thank you very much. Bye.